Hello and welcome. In machine vision applications, matching can be used to count objects, get their position and orientation, and more. In this video, we want to take a first look at shape-based matching with MVTec HALCON. If you already know the basics, have a look at the advanced tutorial. Right now, our example program only displays a series of images. Our goal is to find all circlips that are identical to this one. First, we need to teach HALCON what to look for. For this, we need an image that shows only one circlip. Using this dialog in the graphics window, we can quickly create the region of interest, or ROI. Then, we insert the code. The operator gen rectangle 1 is added. Next, we need to reduce the domain of the image so that only this part of the image is processed. To learn more about images, regions, and domains, check out our tutorial on variables. To finish the preparation, we add the operator create shape model. It creates the model that will be used for matching. Now, we can step into the loop that reads and displays all images. We add the operator find shape model. In the variable window, we can see that a match is found. Its coordinates, angle, and score are displayed. To visualize the result in the image, you can use the procedure dev display shape matching results. When skipping through the images, we can see that the matching works pretty well, despite some of the images being very overexposed or underexposed. That's because shape-based matching is based on contours, not on gray values, and is therefore very robust against illumination changes. In this image, the circlip is oriented very differently. You may have noticed that both create shape model and find shape model have the parameters angle start and angle extent. These parameters allow you to limit the orientations in which the object can be found. A smaller range improves the performance. We extend both operators such that the object can be found in every rotation. If you expect multiple instances of the same object in your images, you can raise num matches. Or alternatively, if you set it to 0, all relevant matches are returned. With these settings, we get good matching results in some very cluttered images. All circlips that have the same shape and size are found correctly. Lastly, you should add the operator clear shape model at the end of your program to free the memory used by the shape model. This concludes our video. You can download the finished program and the program shown in the beginning to try it out for yourself. Take a look at the other matching tutorials to learn about more advanced parameters of shape-based matching and how to process the results of your matching. Thank you for watching.